right to the border. It means that I can pass through the border fairly quickly, get to the car by 6:30, drop everything off, have breakfast, and then be on the way to Sevilla. Be there in good time, especially if I have to fuel up. So we're in really good right now. So it's the price right now, £5.90, it's not bad.
So, 6:45 in the morning, sun is not even up yet. There we go. It's at 6:45 in the morning. Look at
that. I remember seeing the music video for this track. Proper festival song, I love it. It's Take That and Let In the Sun on Forces Radio, BFBS. Now this week we are commemorating the centenary of the Third Battle of Ypres, also known as Passchendaele. This millennium is focusing on one of its victims, Captain Noel Chavas, an army medic whose extraordinary bravery earned him 2 PCs as well as a military cross. In part 4, Liz speaks to documentary.
And if I were to successfully get across the line, I would have been in a very high position to recommend anyone for a posthumous VC.
And that's when the Padre goes on.
Oh, I sank with a sword my arms off.
pardon my language. That was a funny sketch, and then it led to the spam episode.
So,
off we go. I've got the ticket. Clean cut to the right.
We are on our way.
By 6:50, we'll be on the way to Sevilla.
I think a bit shy.
I think we can find the way back. We're probably estimated arrival time be probably around 9:30. No less than that. No. No later than 9:30 in the morning.
But in a way that wasn't if kind of white-blooded and heroic.
Stop over
it was quiet.
Yeah, for stop over for any kind of
it was a
gas. Like we're gonna have to it seems fill up with gas. Again,
because he was
I don't think too much.
There was a doctor basically.
I'm gonna be honest, really not the doctor.
He was tending to wounded men under firing.
Withdrew some money.
He just didn't seem to think about his own dangerous situation.
No, you know, you could argue that he put himself in unnecessary harm.
I withdrew some money so that we'll have enough for the AP score pull
and I think he did think in some way he was being protected by a higher force or doing at least
introduce el ticket, por favor.
Now the first VC tell us when that was awarded to him.
So he got his first VC on the day and night of the 9th of August 1916 in the Battle of Guillemont. That was because he went out and looked after the wounded in no man's land.
That is proof of
pretty much what he did his entire time
for the guy with his HPV.
But he did say that he was lying nice and it was doing beyond
HPV, yes.
At least his family did know about this. I mean, the other one, of course, was posthumous.
El paso, por favor.
Exactly, and I mean, now the extended family that has, of course, grown
there's
since
not
his
much.
Death.
There's not much paso to Ferrer because there's hardly anybody around. I gotta get that silly little flyer off the car.
How do you actually remember
how I hate most people put flyers in the car? Well, I didn't get to have my churros. Maybe I'll have some later.
But there is a commemorative one in Liverpool because that's where he was from. And there's also some commemorative events going on in Ypres itself. And another kind of visit going on in Colchester, yeah. It's going to be a busy time, but a very moving time, I think.
How does it feel to think that a very important part of the Garrison Royal Crossover Coverson is named after your relative?
It feels bizarre, to be honest. I suppose because for such a long time I didn't really know quite how important people thought Noel was.
Tuesday when we were coming this way, it was backed up.
Named after
two blocks over.
Back
is still, I knew.
People tried to name a beer after him.
I've been looking at the Google Maps, the street maps.
It's strange, but it's there.
And I recognize, yes, this is the right way I'm supposed to go as an alternative route.
Thank
so
you very much indeed.
I don't really get that lost.
Whether it does or not, you've got it all there in your head.
I think from here on, it's just find the way to
A7.
I don't know if you come in, sir. What's your story here?
The ultimate forces connection.
Every day.
On Forces Radio.
Yeah, that means watch out for the pedestrians. That's what the strobe lights are doing. So be careful if you're watching this video that you don't have issues with flashing lights at you because you might get convulsions. So be very careful. You see this, I think the city council who put these signs up didn't check to see if all your drivers don't suffer an epileptic condition or something. Luckily I don't, so I'm lucky. So see flashing, I'm not getting, it's not gonna do much to me. It's not much you could do worse, right? With the Wang Chung's Everybody Have Fun Tonight video. Yeah, but I think we'll be alright. So it's 6:45 and the sun, that's like the sun's trying to come up. I think speed-wise we're doing fine. That little, I'll tell you what, the cell phone that Hertz gave is just rubbish. Hardly ever used it after the first day. It's just a disaster. But I'm just saying, nah, I don't use it.
we'll just tell them it was not really useful. The air conditioning units, they're recessed so much that they cannot effectively hold the cell phone properly. Cell phone falls off because the holder gets dislodged too easily. It's just a really bad design to begin with. So it's not like it's broken, it was designed badly to begin with. So what we need to do is we're just going the direction of San Roque, and that's gonna lead us up to the freeway. We'll just head on. Yeah, we're gonna have a bit of a slow time between, I guess, where the exit 118 and A381 goes west to AP4. When we get to 381, it'll be pretty much a 120 limit most of the way up. It's getting close to 7 o'clock in the morning. Conditioner works so much better than the one in my hotel room in Gibraltar. I don't know if you've heard me tell about it. The one in Gibraltar, it's poorly designed. It does not suck the air out quite right. I think it was broken, and the technician, I don't know where he went to HVAC school, but I have him fired. I'm sorry, but I'm from a place where air conditioning, if you have air conditioning, it's supposed to really cool down at least 20 degrees from outside. The air conditioning in my room didn't even come anywhere close. Maybe 5-10 degrees at most. Did you try sleeping in that hot air? And awful. I will come back to Gibraltar on condition that I do not return in the month of August. I will not come in August again. That was really brutal. I'm lucky to have survived. I have, no significant health effects from it, but still, it was not comfortable. Yeah, the air conditioning, if it worked the way it did in Texas, you'd be looking for a new air conditioner. Right? Because that is just unacceptable the way it operated. It just,